We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning thanks to Discover Newport. Chef Lyle Morse is here. Pineapples on the Bay at the Newport Hyatt. Not a bad place to hang out on a sunny, sunny day. Nice to have you. We're going to make chicken salad today.
Yes, we are.
You've got a bunch of ingredients. You said you folks have been really busy because a lot of things are going on down in Newport.
That is correct. We have the Volvo Around the World Ocean Race going on right now. And
right.
We have the SCA ladies headquartered at the hotel. So we've been very busy.
That's great. That's great. So they can get ready for their races. They can have some great food. Chicken salad is what we're going to make. Everybody is like, okay, I may know how to make chicken salad. This you're going to amp it up just a little bit.
This is done with a twist. We have curry in there to give it a little bit of a fusion. And the method of preparation is a little bit different, but I would say on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the most difficult, this would be about a -3.
Okay, so, all right, so let's go over the ingredients that we need for this.
So we have chicken breast. Mm-hmm. It could be the thighs if you wanted to do that as well, depending on your preference.
Right.
We have mayonnaise, red onion, Granny Smith apple. Pineapple could be the canned fresh. I prefer to grill mine because it gives a little bit of a smoky note to it. Toasted almonds for the crunch. Chives, celery, salt and pepper. And mayonnaise, and last but not least, we have some apple juice, which also gives a little bit of a sweet.
Gives a little bit of a sweet taste.
Correct.
All right, sounds good to me. We are going to put this together, try it out, and talk about everything that's going on down at the Newport Hyatt. Back to you.
Back into the why do I always call it the McKitchen? I guess that's what it is. Michaela, take it away.
We can call it that, no problem. Thanks to Discover Newport for bringing in Chef Lyle from Pineapples on the Bay. It is at the Newport Hyatt, which we want to remind people of that because you were saying it's this little well-kept secret.
That is correct. It's probably one of the best well-kept secrets in southern New England. But, you know, from a perspective of the vantage point of the restaurant itself, which is one of three outlets that we have there at the hotel.
Yep.
And by the way, kicking off today, we're opening our official grand opening. Perfect timing with the Volvo race going on.
Yes.
But, you know, it's a stone's throw from the water. I mean, you can actually be sitting out back there and feel like you're on the water without personally being on a boat.
Enjoy a drink, enjoy some great food, and something like this too, this chicken salad, very refreshing. They're throwing in some great pineapple there, and we need to cook the chicken a certain way.
Yes, and what makes this recipe a little bit different, and you don't have to follow the protocol of which I'm showing today, but what I think adds a sweet note to the chicken salad itself is the fact that I'm poaching it in an apple and water mixture. So I've done 50-50 mix here. And I have the water basically at a low simmer, and then we're just going to take the chicken breasts and we're going to lower those right into the apple water mixture.
And you're saying this is apple juice that you could just get.
This is apple juice that you could get from
fridge that your kids
absolutely,
drink, right?
Okay. Absolutely. So you know, if you don't want to do the apple juice, you could just do water.
Mm-hmm.
And we're poaching this, and we're going to cook this to an internal temperature of about 165 degrees.
Okay. So about how long would that take?
This would take probably I want to say about 15 minutes.
Do you need to flip it over?
Okay. Right. I have the stock just barely covering the top of the chicken breast, so you will need to flip it over to make sure that it's cooked all the way through. If you don't have a meat thermometer to get it to 165, you know, take it out on a plate, put a cut in it, just make sure that it's white all the way through and firm to the touch as far as the texture goes.
Cooked. I love the idea of chicken salad because with a lot of barbecues and maybe you're cooking dinner from the night before, if you've got leftovers, a great way to rework it.
It is. It certainly is, and you know, all of the components that go into this, and again, what makes this different from the other chicken salad recipes, the hundreds of recipes that are out there, is the fact that we have all the different textures that are going on.
Perfect.
We have the grilled pineapple.
We're going to get to more of those when we come back. I don't want to give away all your secrets.
Okay,
Chef. We're going to put this together a little later on in the show.
Back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, thanks to our friends at Discover Newport. Chef Lyle Morse is here. Pineapples on the Bay at the Newport Hyatt is the place. We got chicken salad on the menu today.
Mm-hmm.
All
yes,
right,
what are we
doing?
So for the next step, we've been poaching our chicken in the apple in water mix.
Okay.
And it's about really pretty much done, I think.
Okay.
We're going to take that out. And we'll dice that up into about a 1/4-inch dice, as well as all the other ingredients that we have here. If you'd like to cut it up a little bit finer or a little bit more, you're welcome to do that.
Okay.
And then, essentially, everything's going to go in the bowl. I would think about 5 ounces per person would be a good serving size for this. And so we're adding approximately about 1/4 cup of the nuts, the celery, the apple, and the pineapple. And just a smidgen of our curry. Salt and pepper. You don't need a lot of salt and pepper in this because the curry actually adds a savory note as well as the apple juice.
Okay.
And then we have our red onion.
And I like this. It might be a couple different things that people aren't used to putting
yes,
in their chicken salad.
Absolutely, and that's what makes this recipe so versatile. And mm-hmm. again, it's kind of a fusion going on here. And then we'll finish this off with a little bit of our mayonnaise.
Mayo.
Yeah, you need some sort of binder anytime you're making
correct.
One of those.
Yep. Correct. And then essentially we're just going to mix it all up until we get to the consistency. And if you like more curry, well, you're welcome to add more
sure.
if you like to
mm-hmm.
give it a little bit more of the curry essence.
This is good, too, because if you have a lot of guests to please,
right.
maybe someone doesn't like the onions, okay, so you leave onions out of theirs, or maybe, you know.
They have a peanut allergy
right.
or something like that, you
correct.
Don't have to put it in?
Correct. So we've got all of our ingredients mixed together,
mm-hmm.
and I've already gone ahead and taken the liberty of putting some into our slider rolls.
Okay.
If somebody doesn't want the carbs, they can certainly go over mixed greens. I put a little vinaigrette dressing on our mixed
yeah,
greens with the salad
delicious.
There as well.
How is it served over at Pineapples?
We do that actually on a bun. We do it on,
okay.
on a hamburger bun.
Right.
Uh-huh.
And you know we serve that with a lot of different sides as well, with salads, French fries. And you know, a lot of the other offerings at Pineapples we do, you know, it's really regional American cuisine, seafood mm-hmm. specialty. We do calamari. Hyatt's known for a very, very good chowder recipe. So
okay.
If nobody's been down there, they certainly have to try the Hyatt chowder
right.
because
and,
it is excellent.
And you've been very busy with the boat race down there?
Yes, we have. In fact, this weekend kicks off really the grand festivities
mm-hmm.
going on at the Sailing Village at Fort Adams.
Right.
The weather's been great,
weather's
so a lot of people
too.
Are going to start
yes,
making their
sure.
way down
absolutely.
There. Now, all right, let's get a little Rhode Island here. If you're going to give directions as to where you are located, because Newport, it can be confusing,
mm-hmm.
and maybe that's why a lot of people might not realize that you are where you are, because there's so much to do and see when you're down there. So
correct.
Where are you located?
Well, essentially, you come off the Newport Bridge, you
uh-huh.
bear to the right, and you go up. I'm going to say up to the America's Cup intersection.
Sure.
You follow that around by the Goat Island entrance. So we're right
mm-hmm.
on one Goat Island over the causeway. So when you're coming over the Newport Bridge, if you look to the right,
yep.
you can't miss it. We're on the peninsula right out there at the point.
It
right
is
on
a beautiful
Goat Island.
Little spot over
yes.
there. And there is parking once you
There's,
cross
yeah.
over that way, too.
Well, the great thing about Pineapples now, if you go to Pineapples, they offer free valet parking.
Awesome.
Wow. Okay.
Even better.
Yes.
yes.
So you don't have to fight the traffic, and you have
worry-free parking
mm-hmm.
as well.
Correct.
And you were telling me before that you've been there since January. So what have you done to the menu since you signed on?
Well,
because you've been cooking for a while.
Quite a long time,
yeah.
I have, and you know. Coming
he went
into the
Gordon
season.
Ramsay on him, right? You kicked him out.
No, I came into a busy first quarter for sure. There was
right.
a lot going on with the hotel there,
right.
and we had a lot of group business, which
mm-hmm.
was excellent for the hotel. We had a very, very strong first quarter. So
perfect.
I came in, hit the ground running with my head down.
That's, yeah.
Yes.
Are you ready for the summer?
Well, we're ready to go.
I was going to say, this is your first one.
Bat down the hatches.
This is going to be a very good summer for
good.
All of Newport. I think certainly
mm-hmm.
a lot going on. And a lot of opportunities for all the hotels in Newport and all the restaurants.
That's
and
great.
And a lot of variety on your menu.
There is a lot of variety.
Perfect.
We did tweak the menu a lot
mm-hmm.
as opposed to last year. Some more variety as far as the offerings go. Something
nice
for
to hear.
Everybody.
I'm going to grab one. I'm going to grab
okay,
one of these.
Yeah, we're going to chomp
here.
Into those. You can enjoy this delicious chicken salad recipe for yourself. All you need to do is go to roadshow.com for the recipe.